crap's always so expensive. Eh, no thanks.
Ha! I can't stand no one bad-mouthing me spinach. Put him up, yes, big palooka.
Whatever.
Well, blow me down. You ain't got a scratch on you.
I know, right? Overwhelming strength is so boring.
I can't read that.
Oh.
Okay.
A little bit more interesting now.
Wow.
You sure is one crazy gazookas.
I'm just a guy who's a hero for fun. Who the hell are you?
Yep, I am what I am. And that's all what I am.
So, what do you know? I'm gonna get back home.
What the heck?
My muscles ache. I can feel them again.
That's all I can stand, cause I can't stand no more.
I never thought it would happen. A serious fight. I found it! Thank you, weird spinach mascot.
But now he is scrambled. I'm Popeye the Sailor Man.
Okay. Wow.
I guess you could say that fight was over easy. Wait, except isn't Saitama's whole gag that he can't lose?
It is, but it's more nuanced than that. Despite breaking his limiter, Saitama's strength isn't limitless. He's said so himself.
Breaking his limiter meant his potential strength was likely infinite, but there's nothing left in his world powerful enough to push him to get stronger, like a bodybuilder stuck with 5-pound dumbbells.
He also doesn't possess some magical ability to kill someone in one punch regardless of effort. Powerful adversaries like Boros and Gero have survived his blows repeatedly, albeit briefly, and he's never met anyone quite like Popeye the Sailor Man.
According to the mangaka, One Punch Man's gag is that Saitama is an anime protagonist at the end of his series, slapped in at the beginning of his series, where he's too strong to have a challenge.
So, if we know Saitama's strength does have a limit, what is it?
We know he can deflect Boros' planet-destroying blast, but he was clearly super casual about it. He may have called it his serious punch, but that's the joke. He's only now getting kind of serious.
In order to get as generous a number as possible, let's assume Saitama was exerting the least amount of effort he could to throw that punch. Since he's still technically a human, we can assume the ratio between the least amount of effort possible and the most is relatively consistent with other humans. Let's just say he burned the equivalent of only 1 calorie relative to the strongest punch ever recorded, which was over 1,000 joules. For reference, the average person burns about 1 calorie a minute doing absolutely nothing. So this is assuming Saitama is literally as casual as physically possible.
That'd make his strongest punch about 200 times greater than his weakest. Using Boros' energy blast as a base, Saitama's theoretical strongest punch would be over 11 Yoda tons of TNT. That's absolutely insane. Enough to annihilate Uranus 4 times over.
Well, that's impressive, but that's still far less than Popeye's star-busting power, which was millions of times greater. Sure, this is only an estimate. We don't know Saitama's full strength exactly. But the point is, whatever it may be, it can be measured.
That's right, but trying to compare them with just numbers isn't the whole story.
While Saitama can break his world fairly easily, it's still a semi-realistic world that generally obeys the laws of physics.
Popeye and his world, on the other hand, can't really be measured at all. The dude's occupied 2 places at the same time, ripped the film strip he's animated on, and knocked out the guy drawing him. Can't do math to figure that out. Popeye's just on a whole other level of bullshit.
Even if Saitama was strong enough to kill Popeye in one punch, Popeye has survived being fully disintegrated, only to recover good as new. Hell, God turned off all of reality and Popeye just ignored it.
And on the flip side, there was nothing stopping Popeye from just turning Saitama into a bunch of eggs, which he can do without spinach. So even if Popeye was weaker, he'd still have a way to finish the job in one punch.
Saitama was easily one of the strongest combatants we've ever seen, but pure strength was no match for Popeye's insane power, survivability, and plain old cartoon shenanigans.
If you thought nothing could match the One Punch Man, now you know, Popeye's spinach can.
The winner is Popeye.
Mm-hmm. Alright, I can't wait. Alright, start the awesome.